Alright, man, welcome back to yet again another video, and today, boy oh boy, we are gonna be checking out quite possibly the weirdest and the creepiest thing I think I've ever seen come from TikTok. And yes, I am fully aware that is a very loaded statement to make, because TikTok is the same exact platform that'll make literally anything go viral, no matter how dumb it is, bro. Like, you can make the, punch yourself in the face challenge, and then TikTok will get a hold of that and they can get billions of views. However, my example there pales in comparison compared to what TikTok has made go viral in the past 2 weeks, dude, because what we're checking out today is absolutely sickening. So to put it simply, there's a man out there known as Cameron Herron. Now, this fine gentleman right here is currently serving up to 24 years in prison due to the fact he was doing an illegal street race with, I think, one of his friends, and during this illegal street race, he ended up running over a mother, like a 25-year-old mother, and her infant daughter, ending the lives of both of them. Now, obviously, awful guy, right? Deserves to rot in prison for a very long time, because accident or not, this guy is a very dangerous person to have out in society. Anybody this careless and this reckless and irresponsible to the point where they're gonna accidentally just end the life of two people, they're stupid. Like, they're dangerously stupid, and having somebody like that out there can get someone killed, which it did. So obviously that seems like common sense to us normal people, right? You kill somebody, you spend time in prison. However, TikTok would like to disagree with us on this obvious fact, because apparently, according to them, this guy deserves to spend no time in prison because he's quote-unquote too cute to be in jail. Yes, I am not joking. Because a bunch of 14-year-old girls want to have kissy kiss time with this absolute psychopath, they're arguing that despite the fact he killed, he deserves a second chance. And this isn't just some low-key hashtag, bro. This hashtag, I'm pretty sure, has over 2.2 billion views just dedicated to simping for this guy. It's actually nuts. And if you think it can't get worse from here, oh boy, it can. Because the article I found, its headline reads, "Who is Cameron Herron? Hashtag Justice for Cameron TikTok Trend Sparks Controversy," bro. There's a hashtag saying this guy deserves justice even though he can't. Two people. People are campaigning for this psychopath's freedom more than they have, like, any charitable cause I've seen, bro. It's actually sickening. So yeah, let's just check it out, dude. Back in 2018, when he was 18 years old, Herron pled not guilty after K-wording a mother and her one-year-old child while he was street racing in downtown Tampa. The then 18-year-old reportedly collided with the mother and her daughter with his Mustang hitting 30 to 40 miles per hour just prior to the impact. Though, there was evidence to show that he'd been speeding up to 162 miles per hour in events leading up to the crash. So not only is this guy a killer, he's a certified idiot, bro. How are you gonna go 162 down a road where the speed limit is not even half of that, bro? Like, at that point, you're just asking for something bad to happen, either if it's you getting hurt or some innocent people getting hurt, man. Like, oh my god, you were 18 years old, you were a full grown adult. Who gave this guy a license? Walmart? Like, what the Herron ultimately changed his plea and admitted to the crime, but it took until April of 2021 for him to be sentenced by the courts, where he ultimately received a 24-year prison sentence. Users across TikTok and Twitter have, on separate occasions, rallied about Herron's case, demanding his prison sentence be shortened for a number of different reasons, including the difference in sentences that have been issued for similar crimes. The hashtag Justice for Cameron has circulated too, with many users opting to use the line "We are humans, not bots," in an attempt to dispel the notion that bots are being used to boost up the hashtag. I mean, dude, being real, I really wouldn't doubt it if there is some weirdo out there genuinely buying bots to boost the hashtag because, you know, they're just that obsessed with this dude. But I also wouldn't doubt it if there is actually that many people just genuinely simping for this guy and want him to be free because, oh, he's cute or whatever, man. Like, you never really know when we're talking about the TikTokers, man. Let's be real. The hashtag has received support from across the globe too. "We are with Cameron Herron until the end, and we will not leave him," said one fan. "He deserves a second chance. He's a kind guy with a big and open heart," added another. Bro, you have never seen this guy in your entire life. You have never met him in your entire life. How are you gonna be the one to make the judgment? Oh, he's a very kind and open-minded guy. You've never spoken to him, bro. All you know is, oh my god, this guy's a psychopath, but he looks cute and I want to kiss him. Plus, yeah, calling a killer a sweet and open-hearted guy. Very nice judgment you're making there, dude. Like, listen, even as a joke, why would you ever utter the words, "This guy, even though he's a killer, is cute and open-hearted"? Like, shut shut up. For the love of God, please shut up. I'm begging you. The world is begging for you to shut up, man. A TikTok account bearing Heron's name has also jumped to have almost 2 million followers, though many doubters have suggested that this is a work of bots and from those attempting to clear his name. Bro, I actually heard this account they're referencing here was his actual TikTok account that he used to like view videos that had zero followers. So people are out here like going to follow his TikTok account because they think he's cute. Like, bro, I'm sorry. For one, he's a killer. You have to be a special type of weird and creepy to sing for that kind of dude. And number two, in what world is this guy cute? Like, I'm not gay by any means, but let's say I was, I would not find this guy cute at all. Like, why are his eyes so wide open, bro? He looks psychotic. Like, you gotta be one weird, damaged individual to find that man cute, bro. Let me just tell you right now. Okay, so here's some comments that people left on a video about him. The first person said, he killed two innocent lives, took someone's happiness from their lives, and you guys still support him because he is handsome. No, he gets what he deserves. And then the two bottom people are the weirdos, right? Someone says, God help him, and someone said, he deserves a chance. He had a chance, dumbass. He had a chance to live a good life, make good money, have a dream job. I don't know, since he likes racing, be a NASCAR racer, but no, he decided to be all reckless and, oh, let's go out there, put people's lives in danger. No, he deserves to rot in prison. He's an absolute idiot. Now, somebody made a video on TikTok, a pretty good one at that, kind of explaining the entire situation with the simpage stuff, and I just want to read the comments they feature in their video because, oh my goddamn god, they're sickening. Not a killer, as you can tell by that ratio, people didn't like that one too much. Poor boy, I hope they will forgive him. He looks innocent, he didn't do it on purpose. Once again, what do you mean he looks innocent, bro? This guy looks like a genuine psychopath. He looks like the type of guy to kill two people. Oh wait, sorry, that's kind of what he did. In what world does this guy look innocent, bro? Like, I've never seen somebody have their eyes that wide open, even when they try, like, I'm opening my eyes right now, like, I'm using my fingers to spread them open. You can't see it, but even I can barely get them that wide, bro. I swear to God, this guy has to be subhuman or something, dude, I swear. No, it was an accident, poor boy, don't do that. Yeah, accident or not, he took the lives of two people, bro. He's a monster, he's a psychopath, he should not have any mercy at all. You're too cute. I fell in love with a criminal, guys. Laughing emoji. Yeah, bro, laugh it up. What a funny joke, dude. Like, how are you gonna sit here and openly admit to the public that you fell in love with a man who took the lives of two people and not have, like, any inner feelings of guilt or being a weirdo, dude? Because whether you want to accept it or not, falling in love with somebody like this is weirdo behavior. It's weird, bro. And the fact that you're openly contributing to, like, a cause meant to free this man even though he's not innocent, that's weird. That's a problem. How do you not see yourself as a weirdo, bro? Like, oh my god. Some of these people are way too shameless, and it's not only the comments that are the problem, bro. There's actually a change.org petition, if I can actually speak today, dedicated to freeing this man. Look at this. Cameron Heron, 21 years old, jailed for 24 years. Justice for him. Over 27,000 people have signed a petition dedicated to freeing this psychopath, bro. Oh my god. Like, why do people do this stuff, bro? I swear to god, it's stuff like this that makes me lose faith in humanity, bro. Like, not one person should have signed this petition, right? That'd be bad enough, but 27,000 people signing this because, oh, they think he's cute. Like, imagine if that's how the world worked. Oh, your honor, yes, I may have committed the crime. I may have taken the lives of both those people who are totally innocent. However, I am very cute. You know, a bunch of very weird teenage girls on TikTok want to kiss me. I should be free. And the judge is like, oh my god, you're cute? People sent for you? Why didn't you tell me, bro? Oh, case dismissed. You're free. Like, imagine that, dude. And plus, this guy was never known. Like, before, you know, this entire situation, he was never known as anyone. If he was, like, a celebrity and he made good videos or good content, maybe I can understand people being this hyped, but they're this hyped because he looks cute, bro. Like, why? What in the hell? And just to add the cherry on the cake, or whatever the saying is, dude, I really don't give a damn. This dude's own mother came out and said these TikTokers have an unhealthy obsession with her son, bro. Like, if this guy's own mother is coming out and saying, hey, you guys are weird, stop sending for my son, he's not innocent, then you have a problem. Then you know right there and then, yeah, maybe I shouldn't be sipping for this literal criminal, bro. Like, oh my god. And if this video wasn't bad enough, right, if this whole situation wasn't as weird as it is, it gets weirder because people are making literal stand edits of this psychopath, bro. I'll play one for you right now. It's actually sickening.
We'll be right back.
honestly, man, all I want to do is have like a heart-to-heart conversation with one of these absolute Neanderthals, bro. Like, what if it was your mother, or if it was your like infant baby sister that were ran over by this dude? Would you really be too happy to go on TikTok and see people fighting for the freedom of the guy that took the life of your mother and your sister? Oh, what was that? No? Then why would you contribute to this one, dude? Like, this is immensely disrespectful to the family of these victims, bro. Like, imagine being the dad of the daughter and the wife that were murdered, and you go on the internet and you see people just rallying to save the guy that took their lives, bro. I'd be pissed. I'd be heated. Be like, what the hell is wrong with you guys? You guys are absolute sickos, bro. And plus, this kind of stuff encourages people to go out there and do the same exact thing. Whether you want to believe me or not when I say that, people like killers and stuff like that, they get influenced by other psychos. So when they see, oh, this guy, he did what? He took the life of two innocent people and he got praised for it and they're simping for him. Oh, well, I'm a lonely loser with no talent. Let me go out there and do the same exact thing. You see what I'm saying, dude? Like, I don't understand it, bro. I really don't. But yeah, on that note, boys, that is all the headassery I want to check out today. I don't think my brain cells can take this torture any longer. If you guys enjoyed this video and you want to see more like it, just tap where the thing is popping up. Ready to see more? Also, get on below and leave a like. That would mean a lot to me. Go follow my Twitter link below. And also, while you're down there, just tell me how you guys' days have been in the comments below. Can't guarantee I'll get to them all, but hey, if I see you guys commenting on your days have been, I'll do my best to heart them and respond to you guys. But yeah, thank you for watching the video. Truly has been a lot. In conclusion today, TikTok is an absolute cesspit. And yeah, I'll catch you guys. See ya.